हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कंक्लूडिंग पोर्शन ऑफ एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम्स ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल राइटिंग स्ट्रॉन्ग रूट्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन। व्हाई डोंट यू से दिस टू द पीपल हु कम टू यू फॉर हेल्प एंड एडवाइस, आई आस्क्ड माय फादर। So it means people would come to Kalam's father for help and advice, but Kalam's father would not communicate to them. He said that actually human beings are part of the divine being, so they should not be afraid of difficulties, sufferings and problems. So that is why Kalam asked this question. Next, he put his hands on my shoulders and looked straight into my eyes. So putting his hand on my shoulders, he looked straight into my eyes. For quite some time he said nothing, as if he was judging means gazing. My capacity means ability to comprehend his words. Comprehend means understand. His words means his language. So as he was judging, he was actually gazing my capacity, my ability to comprehend, to understand his words. Then he answered in a low, deep voice. Then he answered in a very low, soft and deep means serious, grave voice. His answer filled me with a strange energy and enthusiasm. His answer means the answer of Joinul Abidin, Abdul Kalam's father. His answer filled me with a strange energy and enthusiasm. Energy means vitality. Enthusiasm means strong feeling or excitement. So his answer filled me with a strange energy and enthusiasm. Whenever human beings find themselves alone, as a natural reaction they start looking for company. As a normal reaction they start looking for company. As you know that human beings are social beings, they cannot tolerate loneliness, seclusion, solitariness. Whenever they feel lonely, they search for a company or companion. This is actually the normal reaction for human beings, or to every human beings. Next, whenever they are in trouble, they look for someone to help them. Whenever they are in trouble, they look for someone to help them. So, life is a mixture of joy and sorrow, happiness and misery. So, troubles come and disturb our normal life, normally. But we cannot manage our troubles, and we always look for someone to help us. Whenever they reach an impasse, they look to someone to show them the way out. They reach an impasse means a difficult situation. They look to someone to show them the way out. In real life, people may face a difficult situation, problem. So to overcome this situation, they search for a guide who can show them the right way or the way out of the difficult situation. So they look to someone to show them the way out, right way. Every recurrent anguish, recurrent means happening again and again. anguish means actually indicates physical and mental suffering. So every record and anguish, longing, desire finds its own special helper. So we face naturally anguish, longing and desire in life. So we always find a special helper. Desire finds its own special helper. For the people who come to me in distress, I am but a go-between in their efforts to propitiate demonic forces with prayers and offerings. For the people who come to me in distress, I am but a go-between. Go-between means act as a mediator, middleman. In their efforts to propitiate, propitiate means appease. Propitiate demonic forces means evil forces with prayers and offerings. So in their efforts to propitiate, to appease demonic evil forces with prayers and offerings. Two things, prayers, first one, second one is offerings. So this is not a correct approach at all and should never be followed. So this is not a right approach or correct approach at all and should never be followed. One should never follow the this approach, this path. One must understand, the primary thing is that one must understand the difference between a fear-ridden vision of destiny and the vision that enables us to seek the enemy of fulfillment within ourselves. So destiny means fate. Here Kalam's father speaks about two kinds of destinies, two different destinies, vision of destiny. One is the fear-ridden vision of destiny. This fear makes human being surrender to some supreme power in fear of some danger or peril. This is called fear-ridden vision of destiny. And the second vision of destiny is that our own shortcomings. The second vision of destiny is that our own shortcomings. So at first we should understand the difference between the two vision of destiny. So that is why he said, one must understand the difference between the fear-ridden vision of destiny and the vision that enables us to seek the enemy. To seek the enemy is very much important. To seek the enemy of fulfillment within ourselves. Next paragraph. I remember my father starting his day at 4 a.m. by reading the namaz before dawn. After the namaz, he used to walk down to a small coconut grove we owned about 4 miles from our house, from our home. He would return with about a dozen coconuts tied together, thrown over his shoulders, and only then would he have his breakfast. This remained his routine even when he was in his late 60s. Actually, this is the routine life of Joinul Abidin, APJ Abdul Kalam's father. Routine life. Actually, Kalam's father was a disciplined life. He maintained a routine even in his late 60s. So it is evident that he would start his day at 4 a.m. by reading namaz, actually the Islamic prayer to God, namaz means, by reading namaz. Before taking breakfast, he would go to their coconut grove and return with a load of about lot of about a dozen coconut. This was actually his routine life of Zainul Abidin, APJ Abdul Kalam's father. Next, I have throughout my life tried to emulate means imitate my father in my own world of science and technology. Actually, this was the world of my world means APJ Abdul Kalam's world, science and technology. So, tried to emulate my father in my own world of science and technology. Kalam has tried to follow his father during the whole period of his career as a scientist. Kalam has copied his father. It clearly shows Kalam's admiration for his father. Next, I have endeavored means tried or attempt to understand the fundamental truths means basic or the primary truth. The fundamental truths, I have endeavored to understand the fundamental truths revealed to me by my father, and feel convinced that there exists a divine power means power of God, the power of the omnipotent God. Exists a divine power that can lift one up from confusion, misery, melancholy and failure, and guide one to one's true place. Here, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam's father showed the basic truth of life. As a result, Kalam believes that there is divine power that controls us. This divine power can lift us from confusion, misery, melancholy, and also failure. Clear? Melancholy, failure. And guide one to one's true place. And guide one, when I show the right way, true place. True place means right place. And once an individual severs his emotional and physical bond. His emotional and physical bond. Bond means strong bonding or connection. And once an individual severs his emotional and physical bond, he is on the road to freedom, happiness, and peace of mind. It means when an individual can free himself or herself from the bondage of earthly happiness, he or she can get freedom, happiness and mental peace. This actually indicates the self-actualization and also the self-realization. And it also hints a deep attachment to the material world and feeling. Actually, physical bond has a deep attachment to material world and feeling. So last line is, and once an individual severs his emotional and physical bond, he is on the road to freedom, happiness and peace of mind. Actually, tranquility of mind. So, that's all. Thank you.